Three sparks, sparking the excellence.
Now we will be studying what is normal stress and normal strain. Before knowing what is normal stress and strain, let us study about stress and strain. Let us take a bar, a prismatic bar, in which we apply axial forces. Isme hum tension force dete hain. It is a tensile force which pulls from both the end. Jaise hum pulling force dete hain, the material tries to deform. Material chahta hai ki hum jaise usko khinch rahe hain, there will be a resisting force acting on it, whose direction will be opposite to the direction of the applied force. This is the resisting force. Ye resist karta hai ki material ko na move kare. For take a example in real life, jab bhi koi aapko khichta hai, aap chahte hain ki aap resist karna chahte hain. You don't want to move. That is the thing. Similar here, जब भी ये tension दे रहा है तो जो material है उसका capacity है कि it resists itself, resists the direction. So इसका force, the resisting force है, this will be opposite to it. So if we denote the applied force as P and the resisting force here, then numerically we can say that applied force P is similar to resisting force in magnitude. Magnitude में why it is equal? Because to maintain this body in equilibrium, इसको equilibrium में maintain करने के लिए applied force and the resisting force must be equal. अगर equal नहीं हुआ, अगर resisting applied force ज़्यादा हो जाता है resisting force से, then the body will deform. So within elastic limits, applied force is similar to resistance force. Now let us take a small section to understand about it. Let this be the cross section of the bar. Now we are applying a tensile force here and a similar tensile force here. Upon applying it, and it is the area, this is shown, this is the area of cross section. So how to represent stress? Stress can be written as internal force by area. Internal force is this resistance force. So stress is given as internal force per area. Stress is denoted by sigma. Sigma is equal to P by A. Since internal force is equal to the applied force, we can write internal force by P and area of cross section, this is A. So sigma is equal to P by A. Similar thing happen when we take a bar in compression. If we compress a bar, the internal resisting force tends to act on the direction opposite to it. ये उल्टा direction में act करता है. इसमें हम apply कर रहे हैं उसको bar को compress करना चाहते हैं. मगर जो material है वो compress नहीं होना चाहता. वो चाहता है कि मैं उसको धकेल के and I want to be in the normal state. उसको अपने equilibrium maintain करना है. उसको हिलना नहीं है कहीं. So now if we take a similar cross section and a compressive force acts here. It can also be designated by stress is equal to internal force by area. Internal force can be written as applied force and area can be written as A. Area is this area of cross section on which this internal resistance forces act. And sigma. So the unit is the unit of force is Newton, the SI unit, and the SI unit of area is meter square. So sigma is written, sigma can be, the unit of stress is Newton per meter square. Now this is the concept of stress. Let us understand the concept of strain. Before that we will read why it is called normal stress. Normal stress kyun kaha jata hai? For example, if this is a bar which is subjected to forces like this, the forces we see, this is the, these are the external forces. The internal forces will act in the reverse direction. Jo internal forces hai wo reverse direction mein act kar rahe hain. If this is the axis of the bar, consider this as the axis of the bar, then we see this is the axis of the bar, so it comes under the topic axial deformation, and this is the area of cross section. These are the applied forces. We see that the forces act perpendicular to the area. For example, let us take this example. In this we can find that this is the surface and the force is acting here. Let us consider a tensile force which is acting here. We see that the surface can be denoted by this. This is the surface. and here a force is acting on which direction? In this direction, perpendicular to the surface, and perpendicular is also called normal. You see, so it can be said as normal stress or direct stress. Why normal stress? Is because they act normal to the plane or perpendicular to the plane. Now let us understand the strain. What is strain? Let me consider this as a bar which is subjected to some stress. Okay, so let us consider original dimension. Let this bar be of length L. After applying this force, we find that there is change in length. So the bar changes its length from small L to capital L. With respect to small L, we can write it as delta L plus small L. This is where small L is the original dimension, capital L is the change in dimension. So strain can be written as change in dimension by original dimension. What is the change in dimension? The change in dimension is capital L minus L. So here we write it as capital L minus L divided by original dimension, which is L, the original dimension. So but we know that capital L is equal to delta L plus small L, so we can write this difference, change in dimension, this dimension is changed. Itna hi change hua hai pura. हम जब इसको पुल करते हैं या फिर कॉम्प्रेस करते हैं तो कुछ चेंजेस होते हैं वो बॉडी में, तो उसी चेंज को हम यहाँ डेल्टा एल लिखेंगे. सो डेल्टा एल, फॉर एग्जांपल लीजिए कि एल को हम एक्सपांड करने पर डेल्टा एल इलोंगेट होता है, तो देन इन प्लेस ऑफ एल माइनस एल स्मॉल एल वी कैन राइट डेल्टा एल डिवाइडेड बाई ओरिजिनल डायमेंशन. द ओरिजिनल डायमेंशन वॉज स्मॉल एल. सो स्ट्रेन विच इज डिनोटेड बाय the symbol is equal to delta L by L, and it is a dimensionless quantity. Why it is a dimensionless quantity? Because let's take this example, delta L, what is it? It is length, and the original dimension small l, that's also length. So length divided by length, it gets cut off and it gets a dimensionless quantity.